Greetings, our Hebrew Israelite sisters and brothers. This is L.D. Smith, the watchman on the wall. Israel, it is our Sabbath. Grab that King James. But first and foremost, my sisters and brothers, we want to wish all of you guys a happy Sabbath. Now going forward, we here at loudandminimal.org, we're not going to stop until we expose Lucifer, a.k.a. Jesus, every chance that we get. All right? Now, tonight we got a good teaching. We're going to be coming out of the book of Isaiah, the 55th chapter. And we're going to be looking at verses. A very familiar passage. Verses 8 and 9. All right? Now, Israel, what I want you to do tonight, I want you to think about what we're reading, as I always say. And think about, I want you to listen with a keen ear to hear what the Most High is saying in his words, okay? Because he is going to reveal something to you tonight. Now watch this right here. Let's look at verses 8 and 9, okay? It says, "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, saith the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts." Now Israel, just on that alone, let us try to digest that right there. Let's think about that for a moment. Do you know what he's saying? He thinks like a God. He thinks like one that is out of this little bubble that we're in. See, we can only relate to what we see, hear, taste, and smell. You know, so God is saying that this is the level of your thinking. But his thoughts and his ways are far above, outside this little bubble that we are in. And my sisters and brothers, we have to know our God, okay? We have to know who he is. Now, God is going to reveal the things to us that he wants us to know, all right? Now, think about this right here. Everything that you and I have been taught, and I say everything, I said, you know, with authority. Everything that we have been taught over here in Western civilization and Western philosophy is nothing but a lie. My sisters and brothers, everything that we have been taught is nothing but a lie. And we have to change our way of looking at it, because the true God of the Hebrew Israelites is depicted as a little wimp over the New Testament, but that can be further from the truth. The God of the Hebrew Israelite, he is a terrible God. He does things totally opposite from the New Testament. I'm going to prove it. All right? Now going forward here, let us look at something here. Let us go to the book of Deuteronomy, the 32nd chapter. Let us look at that. Let's go there. Now watch right here, my sisters and brothers. Now, this is the way God thinks. So you and I, as his children, have to think the same way, because this is the attitude and that we're going to have once he comes back. Look what he says. He says, "See now that I am he, and there is no God with me. I make alive, I wound, and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand." Now think about that. Now think, it's so much in that passage. But I want you to think about the last words that he says here. He says, "Neither can any deliver out of my hand." Now you leave it to the Christians. The Christians claim they have rolled somebody back from the dead. They can lay hands on the sick and they shall recover, and they can do all these things. But yet and still, God is saying that I do all these things. And if one really thought about what Jesus teaches, he teaches you to come against God, because he's Lucifer and he was knocked out of his position down here. Now, let's go a little further here. Let us go back to Exodus 20. Now watch it back here, my sisters and brothers. Exodus 20, this is the God of the Hebrew Israelites. Exodus 20 and 13. And look what he says here. God said, "Thou shalt not kill." Talking to Israel. Talking about kill his brother. He's not talking about everybody else. He's talking about thou shalt not kill your brother, because he's giving it to his children, nobody else. So God is saying all the other killing, let me do it. Let me do it. But see, but one might say, how can a God like that be a murderer? Well, let's think about something right here. Okay, in Texas right now, they're having these floods in Oklahoma, and I think it's about 12 or 21 have died, you know, in different ones. But now let's think about this right here. The Christians, they put it on the devil. So the devil did this and devil that. But let me ask you a question, Israel. I know you know the answer, but this is mainly for the Christians. When was the first storm recorded? And who did it? It was the flood, wasn't it? Exactly. Let's take a look at that. Let's take a look at that. Now, let us go to Genesis chapter 7. Let's go there. See, because if God does that, then that doesn't leave any room for anyone else. Genesis chapter 7. Let's look at verse 21 and 22. Look at this God right here. I'm going to show you how he is. He's nothing like the one that is depicted in the New Testament. Look what he says here. He says, and all flesh died. Huh? All flesh died that moved upon the earth, both fowls and cattle and beasts, and of every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth, and every man. All right? He said, in all, he said, all in whose nostrils was the breath of life, and all that was in the dry land died. And that's this the God that you serve, Israel. He killed everything but Noah. But now to show you how dangerous God is, and that he is one that don't play. Murder is one thing. But how about premeditated? Huh? That's what I said. How about premeditated murder? Let's look at it. Let's back up to chapter 6 in Genesis. Let's look at chapter 6 in Genesis. Let's look at 11, 12, and 13, and 14. All right? Look what it says. Chapter 6 in Genesis, verse 11, it says, the earth also was corrupt before God, and the earth was filled with violence. 12. And God looked upon the earth and beheld it was corrupt, for all flesh had corrupted his ways upon the earth. And God said to Noah, the end of all flesh is come up before me. That's premeditated. God had planned this thing even before he did it. That makes him a murderer and a killer. But God is God, and all of his ways is just. Now watch right here, Israel. Let's go a little further here. Look what he says. He says, all flesh, he says, the end of all flesh is coming before me. In 13, he says, for the earth is filled with violence through him, them, and behold, I will destroy them with the earth. God is premeditating. God is planning on how he's going to kill man and all of his creation, but Noah and his family. Now look what he said. He said, make thee an ark of gopher wood. Room shall thou make in the ark, and shall pitch it within and without with pitch. Now God has premeditated. God has premeditated to kill all the life that's on the planet, but that which is inside the ark, including the serpent that beguiled a woman. Because he said all that breathes breath in his nostrils, so that means that the serpent life ended there too. My question is, how can the serpent come up again in the book of Revelations? And the old dragon and the devil, all these other names that Lucifer gives the devil and Satan. But anyway, let's go a little further, my sisters and brothers. Let us look at, let's go to St. John. Watch this right here. St. John chapter 8. Watch this right here now. We already see that God is a premeditated murderer. Am I right or wrong? But all of God's ways are right. St. John 8:44. Watch the word of Israel. Watch this. St. John 8:44. Look what he said. He says, ye are of your father the devil, and the lust of your father ye will do. Now listen to what he said now. Listen, he says, your father, talking, so-called talking to Israel. And look what he says. He says, he was who? Your father was a murderer from the beginning and abound not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it. Okay, all right. Now let us break this down right here. He says that your father is the devil and he is a murderer. Now we know that God premeditated killing everybody on the planet. So we know that he's talking about God. We know that. But without a shadow of a doubt, we know that this is who he's talking about. But if you don't see it already, I'm going to prove it to you. I'm going to prove it to you, all right? Now, watch this right here. Let's go to St. John 8. Let's look at verse 39. Watch this right here now. He says, they answered and said unto him, Abraham is our father. Okay? And look what he said. Jesus said, Jesus answered and said, If ye were Abraham's children, ye would do the work of Abraham, right? Now to show you guys how big a liar this fucker is, that he ain't shit. He ain't nothing but a liar. He's nothing but a demigod. He ain't nothing. Now you heard what he just said. He said, if you were Abraham's children, you would do the work of Abraham, right? Watch out, I nail his ass to the wall. Let's look at verse 37. Look at verse 37. St. John chapter 8, look at verse 37. Look what he says here. I know that ye are Abraham, what? Oh, I know he didn't say that, did he? He just said down here, he said, if you were, you do the work. Then he comes up here and say, I know who you are. He said, I know that ye are Abraham's seed, but you seek to kill me because my word has no place in you. Now, my sister and brother, how can that be? So we see here, if he say that, I know that you're Abraham's seed, that mean that they came from Abraham. And Abraham came from God, because God says, I am the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Want to see it? Okay, let's go here. Let's go to Exodus 3. What's it right here? Let's go to Exodus. Is that Exodus 3 I want to go to? Exodus 3:15. Exodus 3:15. Let's go there. Watch it right here, my sisters and brothers. Exodus chapter 3, verse 15. Look at what it says here. And God said moreover unto Moses, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, nobody else, the Lord God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob has sent me unto you, because he told me, say, who should I tell them? You know, that sent me. Then he said, this is my name forever. So he can't be the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, and the God of Jesus, because he said, this is my name forever. And he goes on, look what he says here. He says, and this is my memorial unto all generations. In other words, that's what I want you to tell every generation, that I am the father of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Now, he's talking about every generation according to the Hebrew Israelites. Nobody else. Nobody else. Now, with that being said, let us go a little further here. God is an awesome God. Let's look at Deuteronomy 32 again. Let's go there. Deuteronomy 32. Let's look at that that scripture in there. 4. Look what he says here. He says, he is the rock. His work is perfect. For all his ways are judgment. And all his ways are judgment. A God of truth and without iniquity. Just and right is he. But if you look at John 8:44, Jesus said that their father God, he has no truth abiding in him at all. And say when he speaks a lie, say he's the father of lies. And say when he speaks a lie, he speaks of his own. So we see here that he's clearly talking about God, the Most High. He's talking about the Most High. He's not talking about somebody else. He's talking about the Most High because he's talking about who is your father. He said, Abraham. He said, I know Abraham is your father. This is not that I think. He said, I know. So when you trace them back to Abraham, and God, the Most High, say he is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So who else could Lucifer, a.k.a. Jesus, be talking about but the Most High? My sisters and brothers, this is right in the pages. I mean, I can't do anything else. But watch this right here. Let's go to Isaiah 44. Watch this. Let's go to Isaiah 44. Isaiah 44. Let's look at verse 8 here. Look what he says. Fear ye not, neither be afraid. Have I not told thee from that time and declared it? Ye are even my witnesses. Is there a God beside me? Yea, there is no God. I know not any. God said, I've been telling you this from way back. Way back, I've been telling you this. Ain't nobody besides me. So when another joker pops up on the scene and tell you that he came from me, hey, that's nothing more than bullshit. He says, I've been telling you this from way back. Ain't nobody but me. But then Jesus pops up and then say, well, I came from him, and then y'all believe it. He says, I've been saying the same thing over and over. Now, anyway, let's go a little further here. Let me show you how God, how terrible the Holy One is. Let's look at Exodus 23. Let's go to Exodus 23. Watch this right here. Exodus 23. Let's look at 20 and 21. Look what it says here. It says, behold, I sent an angel before thee to keep thee in the way. Talking about Israel. And to bring thee into a place which I have prepared. See that? God always have prepared a place. God is business, but he is also serious. He's serious about obedience. God does not play. I don't care what the New Testament depicts him as, this little wimpy ass God. No. I'm telling you, he is not to be fooled with and jacked around with. God will do something to you that you will never be able to recover from. Now look what he says here. Verse 21 says, beware of him and obey his voice. Provoke him not, for he will not pardon your transgressions. For my name is in him. See that? God saying, I'm the king. I have given him permission. I've given him the okay. As a matter of fact, I have stamped it, approved. Don't play with him. He'll do something to you. Now, my sister and brother, let's go a little further here. Let's look at Psalms 7. Let's go to Psalm 7. Psalm 7. Let's go there real quick, my sister and brother. Psalm 7, let's look at verses 11 and 12. Psalm 7, verses 11 and 12. Let's look at this right here. He says, God judges the righteous And God is angry with the wicked every day. And look what he says here. He said, if he turn not, he will whip his sword. He has bent his bow and made it ready. See that? God says he has also prepared for him the instrument of death. He will ordain his arrow against the prosecute. God does not play. Many times we think that God is playing. He's nothing like the New Testament. God will do something to you. Now let's look at a little further here. Watch this right here now. Let us look at Deuteronomy 20. Let's go back here to the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 20. Watch it right here, my sisters and brothers. Watch this. Show you how God is. Chapter 20. Very familiar passage. We talked about this in another teaching, but it needs to be, you know, did over. Look what it says here in chapter 20, verse 16 and 17. Look what it says. He says, but of the city of those people which the Lord thy God doeth giveth thee for an inheritance, thou shalt save alive nothing that breathes. See that? But thou shalt utterly destroy them, namely the Hittites and the Amorites and the Canaanites and the Perizzites and the Hivites and the Jebusites, as the Lord thy God hath commanding. See that? And look what he says in verse 18. To let you know that he does not want you to mix and mingle with other races. Look what he says. He says that they teach you not to do after all their abominations which they have done unto their God. So should you sin against the Lord your God. See that? God continues to say, when you mix the races, when you go into other nations and other races, they will take you away from me. And we see it all the time. I mean, all these big evangelists, so-called, on television, T.D. Jakes and all of them, you know what I mean? He's all mingled up with something else. He's one of Lucifer's cronies. That boy over there in Ohio, Ron Parsley, the list goes on and on. They all of them nothing but liars. And they after your money. But anyway, let's go a little further here. Let us go to the book of Joshua. The book of Joshua. Joshua 6. Now let's look at verse 21 and 22 here. Look at Joshua 6, 21 and 22. He said, and they utterly destroy all that was in the city, both men, women, young and old, and ox, and sheep, and ass, with the edge of the sword. But Joshua had said unto two men that had spied out the country, go into the harlot's house and bring out hence the woman and all that she hath, as ye swore unto her. Now here we are. God said, go in and kill everything, all the animals, everything, but save the whore. But today's teaching is that, you know, that's a bad person over there. They talk about them, you know, but here this person was so-called so good. But one thing is certain, if you line them all up, they got a day with death. You know, the so-called good one, they'll say good words over them, but that does not change their situation. Their ass is still in the pine box. But yet it's still the one that was so-called a whore. The so-called bad one, huh? She was a bad person. But think about it, it doesn't change her state, neither her condition. So why even talk about that person was so-called good? The only ones that are good is God's chosen people. And those are the only ones that God is concerned about. Now, let us move a little further here. Let us go down here to let us go here to Exodus 29. Exodus 29. Let's go there real quick. Watch this right now, my sisters and brothers. Exodus 29. Let's look at 44 and 45. Exodus 29, verses 44 and 45. Look what it says. It says, and I will sanctify the tabernacle. Exodus 29, 45. Yeah. He said, and I will sanctify the tabernacle tabernacle of the congregation and the altar. And I will sanctify all, sanctify also both Aaron and his sons to minister unto me in the presence in the priest's office. Now look what he says there, verse 45. Here's the one that I'm talking about. And I will dwell among the children of Israel. See that? This is what God wants to do, and this is what God is going to do when he comes back. God wants to be with his people. He said, I'm going to dwell among the children of Israel and will be their God. Nobody else. Nobody else. God wasn't with nobody back here, and he damn sure is not going to be with nobody else when he comes back. He's coming back for only Israel. Nobody else. My sister and brother, we hear a lot of me no more, daughter. We wish you a happy Sabbath. Until next time, my sisters and brothers, shalom.